everybody. Prelim and outlook for April 22nd, 2009. Welcome to FX Bootcamp. My name is David Pegler. Remind you that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not a load service. I will not make any trade recommendations during the course of a day. However, what I will do is conduct a fundamental and technical analysis, hopefully help you put together some good profitable trade plans. Please keep in mind trading is always risky when you leverage 100 to 1. Occasionally, this leverage will work for you. Unfortunately, more times than not, it's going to work against you. So please do not trade real money until you have a good proven track record of success on a demo account. Okay, guys, well, what I got you looking at here for the time being is a 4-hour euro pound chart, probably a chart that I haven't flashed in front of you nearly as much, and something that we use every single day to determine relative strength. You know, a year ago, the euro pound really wasn't an entity, really. You know, it was all about the USD and the yen, but lately there's been, you know, discrepancies in relative strength between the euro and the pound and the Swissie. Therefore, the pound Swissie and the euro pound have actually been very tradable, and frankly, the euro pound has been a key element in intraday analysis for determining relative strength. So today, you know, this is once again, this is a 4-hour euro pound. You'll notice that we're in this pretty well-defined trap for euro pound, and really, you know, while we're bouncing around in here, it's going to be more about what the USD is doing than what the pound and the euro are doing individually as currencies themselves. However, if we break to the upside on this euro pound trap, you know, you've got to be thinking 9100 almost, and then you've got to be thinking 9100 almost, and if we break to the downside, obviously that's going to mean significant pound strength. But the bottom line is that it's not really about where we're going here. I'm not building a trade plan around this at all. It's got to do with it's got everything to do with which way this is going to go in terms of how we're going to trade the pound and the euro as individual currencies. Because if we break to the downside here, that's going to force the euro USD down further, and, you know, maybe cause the pound to go up, give the pound some relative strength, and really send the pound Swissie through the roof. So, you know, all I'm showing you here is really identifying a pretty well-defined trap that the euro and the euro pound is in, and whichever way this breaks is going to give us a huge heads up as to the relative strength between the euro and the pound. Okay, so keep an eye on that today. Pretty well defined little trap. Today's little trade plan actually comes from the euro yen. So let me cruise over there. Okay, this is a daily euro yen chart, and what you'll notice is a couple of things. Okay, we have absolutely hit support. This trend line coming off the bottom was critical, not to mention the support line at 126, which we touched yesterday. It looks a lot like our pound yen chart on a daily. However, what you'll notice that we're making a series of lower lows and lower highs, okay, folks? So that, on a daily level, despite the fact that we're coming off support, is a daily downtrend, okay? So what we want to do is really identify areas in the context of this downtrend that we would like to be finding reason to short, okay? Now, by virtue of the fact that we've come off support, tells me that we're on our way back to a fib of the entire move. So that actually intimates that we could have ourselves some decent longs looking for that fib to the downside. So where is that? If we go to the 4-hour, okay, and pull a fib of the last major swing, okay, this 129.20 area, this 129.20 area is also the 4-hour 200 EMA, plus this old visual supported 129.60 area. So this whole zone for me is going to be resistance, okay? Now, if you take a fib of this swing, this is the 382 of that swing. So what I'm looking for now, hopefully, is obviously a quick little move down, and we find support around 127.50-ish, and then move on up to this 129.50-ish area, and that'll give us a good short opportunity, trying to short in alignment with what's happening on that daily and the 4-hour level at resistance, and that'll be a good limited risk, high reward type setup, and then hopefully push down through that 126 area. So that's basically my trade plan. Trade us up to that 129 area, and then look for reasons to short off 129.50 to 129.90, looking for that 126 handle again, okay? So that's my little trade plan. Very, very, very simple stuff. Looking to short in alignment with the daily downtrend at resistance, and looking to long off the newly redefined uptrend on the 15 minutes into the context of that daily downtrend, okay? So a pretty good little look at you know, market fractals, support and resistance, and then just you know, evaluating the different time frames and taking the different trends in context with that time frame, and then translating that to the longer term charts. Okay, so good luck further today, folks. My name is David Pegler, Prelim Outlook, April the 22nd. Catch up with you tomorrow.